Shaitan promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala four things. He said, وَلَأُضِلَّنَّهُمْ. He said, I will lead them astray. And you look at majority of humanity today, instead of becoming the servants of Rahman, they are the servants of Shaitan. Then he said, وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. And he said, I will give them unto their false passions and their desires. And subhanAllah, you can broadly define false passions and desires into two. One are your carnal desires, your desire for the flesh. And you look at our society, how it has succumbed to the wish of Shaitan. Really, you look into our society today, that it is a sex-driven society. It is a sex-mad society. That the society promotes sex as long as you have safe sex, because according to them, it's a physical thing. You carry on. Whilst Islamically, it's a spiritual thing. When a husband comes to his wife, he recites du'as, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguards that child. And the ulama write that this is the first right of the child, because it's a spiritual thing. And you look at our society today, that if by the age of 16 you haven't broken your virginity, there's something wrong with you. This is what society promotes. And this is why, out of the seven people who will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, will be that young man, nasha'a fi ibadatillah, who grew up in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first form is your carnal desire. وَلَأُمَنِّيَنَّهُمْ. I will give them unto the carnal desires. The second, that shaitan will delude you in believing into false aspirations of this dunya. He will make you believe in false aspirations of this dunya. And he will make this dunya the purpose of your life. Not only will he make this dunya the purpose of your life, he will not give you time to even think about the purpose of your life. And subhanAllah, how you see how the promise of shaitan is coming to pass. You know, they give you your TV sets, and then they give you your videos, and then they give you your DVDs, and then they give you your satellite channels, so you have more channels than you can even count. And then they give you your mobile phones, and then they give you your voice activated mobile phones, and then they give you your camera phones, and then they give you your video phones, and then they give you the internet, and then they give the internet on your mobile phone, like so that the posters say you can shop until you drop dead. And when you drop dead, the same shaitan will say, La talumuni, lumu anfusakum. Don't blame me, blame yourself. I called you and you obliged. And you will be suckered like the billions who were suckered before you. The billions who were suckered before you. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, La tansa nasibaka min ad-dunya. Do not forget your portion of this dunya. And Imam Qurtubi says, your portion of this dunya is your kafan. Your portion of this dunya is your kafan. That the only thing that you will take from this dunya is your kafan. The third promise of shaitan was, وَلَأْمُرَنَّهُمْ فَلْيُبَتِّكُنَّ أَذَانَ الْعَنَامِ. I will command them and they will slit the ear of the cattle. What the mushrikeen would do is that they would slit the ear and they would slit the animal, and they would let on the name of their gods, and they would let it walk. Author of Tafsir al-Mazri mentions that this means that a time will come where shaitan will tell man to disfigure the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you see this today, really. You look into our society, a consumer society, where they try to create chickens without feathers. They try to create chickens without feathers, where recently in Switzerland they found a fruit fly, and from that fruit fly they found a gene which they dubbed eyeless. And when they noted that wherever they injected this gene, an eye would grow. And they injected this gene on 14 places of this dragon, or this fruit fly, and on 14 places on the anatomy of the fruit fly, eyes grew. See, this is man playing God, playing with the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it doesn't stop there. You look at those who reach the pinnacle of success. Really, look at those people who reach the pinnacle of success. Those like Michael Jackson. You know, the guy was a good-looking person a few years ago. But he reaches the pinnacle of success and then he's deluded by the dunya. He even thinks that there must be some more contentment out there. But doesn't really realize that the only contentment is the contentment of the heart. The only time you can really have contentment is when you recognize your creator. And then what does he do? He starts playing around with his features. He starts disfiguring his features. And now you look the way, the guy doesn't even look like a human being. And the fourth promise of shaitan is, وَلَأَعْمُرَنَّهُمْ فَلْيُغَيِّرُنَّ خَلْقَ اللَّهِ. I will command them and they will change the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. You know, the traditional interpretation for this verse was to shave the beard was to change the creation of Allah, because this was a sign of a man. To pluck the eyebrows was a sign of change, a sign of changing the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But because the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transcends time and space, it is relevant for all time, because it guides us until the final day. Today, it relates to your GM foods. This is changing the normal process, changing the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, when they take the antifreeze gene from the Arctic fish and they inject it into your tomatoes so they have longer shelf lives, this is playing with the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because believe it or not, fish don't have relationships with tomatoes. It doesn't work like that. This is GM food. You're playing with the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But worse than that is those who come on the TV set and they say, oh, I'm a man caged in the body of a woman. I'm a woman who's in the body of a man. And these are people who changed the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look, what could be a greater change in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What could be a greater change in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That a man transforms into a woman and a woman transforms into a man. And this was the fourth promise of shaitan. And you see it coming to pass today. What greater change could there be? That a man becomes a woman and a woman becomes a man. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, hold on to the book of Allah. فِيهِ نَبَأُ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ وَخَبْرُ مَا بَعْدُكُمْ وَحُكْمُ مَا بَيْنَكُمْ. And the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a hukum between you. It is a thing which passes verdict between you. هُوَ الْفَصْلِ لَيْسَ بِالْحَصْلِ. It is a thing which differentiates between right and wrong, and it is not jest. And if you take it as jest, then listen to the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Man tarakahu min jabbarin qasamahu Allah, wa man ibtagha al-khuda fi ghayri adallahu Allah." Listen to the words again. "Man tarakahu min jabbarin qasamahu Allah, wa man ibtagha al-huda fi ghayri adallahu Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever seeks guidance is other than the book of Allah, because of arrogance, because he believes that guidance lies in some other philosophy, some other ideology, other than the book of Allah, then Allah will break his neck. Allah will break his neck. And whoever seeks guidance in other than the book of Allah, Allah will lead them astray. Really, really, you don't have to go past these two sentences to understand why the Muslim Ummah is in the decadence that it is in today. Do you? The Prophet ﷺ articulated this 1400 years ago, that when the Muslims will think that their honor lies somewhere else, that Allah will disgrace them. Look at the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. These were a group of people who were regarded by the rest of humanity as full of safilin. And then the Prophet ﷺ came and he transformed these people. He brought an impetus, he brought a drive, and this was Islam. And then these very people who were regarded as the worst of people became the best of people to walk upon this earth after the Anbiya alayhim salatu wasalam. What was it? It was Islam. See, for other people, other philosophies will work. For other people, other ideologies will work. But for the Muslims, nothing besides Islam will work. Because this is Ummah regarding what Allah, the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala articulates in the Quran. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. Ta'maruna bil ma'roof wa tanhawna 'anil munkar. That you are the best of creation. You are taken out for mankind. Now, if you think that your izzah lies in some other philosophy and ideology, you're deluded. The only time the Muslims had respect were when they held on to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at history. And then when they turned away from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah turned away from them. And this is why we find ourselves in the decadence that we do today. Look at the state of the Muslims. And until we realize that the problem that we have today is because we have turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we go back to the Quran and the Sunnah, we go back to the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and find our remedy. But the problem is that we look for remedies everywhere else other than where we should. And this is why we're in a sick state. Aren't we sick today? Aren't the minds of the youth confused? What should we hold on to? Aren't the hearts sick? Because society has many impulses. It will tell you, pull you in many directions. And then the more direction you go, the more confused you will be. Because we are pulled in so many directions. The minds are sick. The hearts are sick. The brains are confused. And the only thing which remedies seasickness is what? That when you come up to the top deck, and you look at something which is totally straight, like the horizon, then all the confusion is removed. And similarly, there is only one guidance for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states this in the beginning of Surah Qaf. He says, Alhamdulillahi allazi anzala ala abdil kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has revealed on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his servant, a book, and he has left no crookedness in it.